At the beginning of the summer, I was not totally sure if the marine semester would happen or what it would look like if it did. It was really up in the air, as was literally everything. But I signed up for it anyway because
it makes you feel like you're a part of something bigger than just a class.
There's so many branches off of marine biology or marine sciences. It's all really interesting. And you kind of want to dip your toes in everything. And what the marine semester does, it kind of just shows you what these actual field researchers are doing. It's one class per block, so there's four blocks, so you're taking four classes total. Every block is an intensive research class, so you're out there collecting data, you're going out into the field.
In a normal semester, you don't have the time to spend one day out in the field somewhere collecting data. So the marine semester allows you to only take that one class at a time for a short period and sort of devote all your resources to that. Our program managers have done a really good job of adapting the program to the current situation.
The field work and the lab work are proceeding almost exactly as before. You wear your mask, you keep your distance, but other than that, it really feels almost like normal. Estuaries and nearshore systems is a really great view into how the marine semester works. You're doing really exciting, engaging work, but it feels just like a fun field trip into the mud with your friends. We measured the impacts of disturbances on the marsh. So I specifically worked to measure the length and the density of different marsh plants in an area that had been covered by mud and sediment after a storm event in 2018. So by doing that every year, for the last few years and continuing, we can see how the marsh is able to grow back. And that tells us a lot about how the marsh will be able to stabilize after climate change-induced flooding or increased frequency of storm events.
Marine urban ecology is a class that focuses on how the city of Boston affects marine ecology as a whole. A lot of the times, ecology tries to take humans out of the equation, but we can't just ignore the fact that we're here and that we are actively changing the ecosystem. And so what we did was we went down the three rivers that feed into the Boston Harbor, and we looked at water quality, we looked at how much trash is on the riverbanks, and we tested for salinity and temperature and dissolved oxygen just to see the health of the rivers. And the health of the rivers tells us a lot about what is being fed into the ocean.
So typically the tropical marine invertebrates class travels to Belize and collects samples that are brought back and later processed. This year, because we were unable to travel, we had the really unique opportunity to take those samples from previous years in Belize and work with them.
So we're looking at the sponge communities in mangroves, the different symbionts, so things living inside of the sponges. It's a lot of scope time, but it's always fun to learn new taxa, new species. I didn't expect us to actually be in class, so it's nice that we kind of jumped over that hurdle and we're making the best out of it.
Normally at this time in coral reef dynamics, we would be snorkeling in Belize every day in crystal clear waters to learn about how coral reefs function in real life. And so we would be seeing what fish live there, what organisms live on the reef, how the reef survives. But now, because of the pandemic, we have to do that virtually. So what we did on the first couple of days of class was collect a bunch of objects that we have in our rooms and build the Great Terrier Reef. We could then learn how to use the software that everyone who went to Belize in the years prior used to create photo mosaics. A bunch of pictures stitched together to create 3D replications of the reef. This is a way that is really good at analyzing data from reefs that you can't necessarily get while you're in the field. I think what I learned about myself through this is that it is okay for things not to go how you plan them to. And when it doesn't, that is just an opportunity to learn something new.
I've absolutely been amazed at how well the semester's gone. We're all very happy to still be here doing meaningful work.
I've now seen effects of rising sea levels. I've seen ecosystems start to decline, and it's confirmed that, you know, this is what I want to be doing, that I want to be a scientist, and that I can be a scientist.